Hello, welcome to another Racket Review. I'm Tennis Rally, and today I will be reviewing the new Dunlop CX200 Tour 18x20 that is going to release now in 2021. This is one of two videos I will be publishing. The second one is a comparison between the old 16x19 version and the new one, but this video will focus only on the 18x20. So the CX line from Dunlop consists of many different models, including this one, and the CX stands for control, so it's mainly targeted on control. The two other lines are SX and FX, and they are targeted for spin and power. This 18x20 version of the CX line is the most controlled of the bunch, with a thin beam, dense string pattern and a small head size. This will be resulting in a highly advanced racket which demands a lot from the player, who needs solid strikes with good technique and good footwork in order to make use of the racket's full potential. So the racket specs you can see on the screen. We have a 95 square inch head size, standard 27 inches length, weight unstrung is 315 grams or 11.1 ounces. Balance 310 millimeters, swing weight strung is 319, string pattern 18x20, beam width goes constant from 20.5 millimeters all the way through. Stiffness on the racket it says 63 RA, but listed on Tennis Warehouse it says 62, so around 63-62. Power level is really low, and the strings used was Headlings Tour at 24 kilos or 53 pounds. Before we continue, I just wanted to remind you to subscribe to the channel if you enjoy what you see, and if you want me to continue with these reviews. I really enjoy doing them and I want to keep doing them. So this is an extremely controlled racket, you can tell by based on the specs, and I had to put in a lot of effort by playing to get some pace and spin on the ball. I can't say this frame suits me or my play style really, since it demands hitting the sweet spot almost perfectly every time and generating a lot on your own. But when you hit the middle with perfect timing, it almost becomes effortless. The issue is that this rarely happens in match play and only on practice, which then becomes almost useless. The difference in match play and practices is always or almost the fact that in match play it gets a little bit faster, quicker, you don't think as much, you don't get the ball to your body as perfect, which on practice you can do drills and you get the ball perfect every time. But my favorite shots with this racket was the drop shot. The feel of this racket is really nice, and I felt really connected and confident to hit drop shots. Almost all shots that requires great feel felt good. The slice, volleys, drop shots and so on. Serves worked quite good as well. I didn't get enough pop, I thought, but my placements and my second serves were very solid throughout the playtest and worked great overall, but I would like some more power. The differences between the 18x20 version and the 16x19 are the string pattern, of course, the weight and the grip. The 18x20 version is 5 grams heavier, with a denser string pattern, and it comes with a leather grip in stock form instead of a synthetic grip. So when comparing these two models, there is not much of a difference. The 16x19 has a slightly higher launch angle over the net, a bit more spin potential, and it's a tad more forgiving and powerful. You still have to put in a lot of work using this frame, but both the 16x19 and 18x20 would need some customization and some weight to get it more stable. Because the 95 square inch head is pretty small and requires more weight. So in conclusion, this is a very controlled racket, great for touch shots and perfect ball placements, primarily made for an advanced player who likes to come forward to finish off the points quickly and effective, or just an aggressive baseliner who needs extra control and precision. So don't forget to check out my other reviews and the upcoming comparison of the 16x19 version, and subscribe for even more content and follow me on Instagram so you never miss another video. And that's all for me. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye.